Right, YouTube, how's it going? Buster again. Not doing a wee video since I'm half up today again. My videos are not going to be every week on a certain day or anything. I'll just be when if I've got time to do them. More varies, and with this shit that's happening, I really don't know what work's like and days off and stuff like that, so I don't know. Today it's going to be about this Jim Deacon. Very underrated guitar, very underrated. I'd put it up there with build quality the same as the Squire Vibe. But the price of the Squire Affinity, probably cheaper if you can find them. I've seen them go for anything between 20, 30 quid all the way up to 120 quid. But they're very underrated for the fact that they don't have Fender or Squire on, which I think's a lot. I like Fenders and I like Squires and I like all different types of guitars, but this one, definitely. When I bought it, I thought, Jim Deacon, and I played it, amazing guitar. The only thing I did to it was I changed the bridge to a Squire bridge, because this came off of my Duff McKagan, I'll call it, Squire. So I put this on this. Well, the reason why was because the one that was on it was manky. Pickups are exactly the same, original. Pots are original. P-bass standard, volume, tone. It's got a mint green pickguard. I did have a mother of toilet seat pickguard on it, but I took it off and put this back on because it looks a lot better. Aqua blue, matching headstock. You see, Jim Deacon. That signature there. That's the early 90s one. So if you're going to buy one, I would suggest buying the early 90s Jim Deacon. It's got a roasted maple neck. Here my output jack, going a bit funny there. Roasted maple neck, skunk stripe. It looks like it's got clay dot inlays, but obviously they're not. Really cool guitars. I'll do a review. I'm going to show you my Squire. I've got a Squire P bass. I've also got another P bass. A few other things I'm doing. But these are very underrated. So, for what I've read, because I wanted to know about these as well, the Jim Deacon was a brand name imported by the Scottish Musical Instrument Retailers Association in the 90s. People think they're caught, maybe being caught. So, this is an early 90s one. And Fender have just brought out recently guitars like this, the aqua colour, aqua headstock, reissued them. And when people see this for a distance, they think it's a Squire or it's a Fender, but it's not. I was going to do something with the headstock and cover the Jim Deacon, but I'm not going to bother because I quite like. I said, so you want to get one with the roasted maple neck. Or that signature, that's the early 90s one. So I'm going to let you see it. I do apologise for, I'm a bit rusty playing standing up for the fact that I broke my leg 14 weeks ago. And I've been playing sitting down while my legs broke. So I'm a bit uneasy playing standing up. I feel like it feels a bit weird now after all that time sitting down playing. So excuse me if my playing's a bit off. So I'll let you get it. Guitars, 90% of my guitars have all got roto sounds on them. I love roto sound, as you can see. Roto sound. But can use this for pretty much any plane. I like a wee bit of rage against the machine. Normally, drop D, which will probably show you another guitar that I use, but you can do it. So I really need this guitar. I say if you can get one of these, pick one up, especially the early 90s one, because it's just as good, if not better, than a Squire. Really nice. They do, I've seen them do jazz basses as well, but the B bass is definitely, this is one of the better B basses I've seen. I think I've only ever seen another one of these, and it was red. So really nice if you can get one, pick one up. Especially with the fake or roasted maple neck. Very, very good guitars. So, thanks for watching. See you soon.